So what Google Classroom does is it organizes everything for you. Ooh. So you're able to create an assignment, and when students submit it, it all goes to the same folder for that assignment. Students are able to respond in real time, and you can even project it to show the classroom, and you guys can discuss it together. So I'm gonna show you some ways I've done that with my kids, and ideally, you guys would be able to participate too, kind of as my students, through Google Classroom, so you can see what the kids see. So, to begin, what is your experience with Google Classroom? To answer as a question, what you would do is you would click on it, and as a student, you would answer one of the questions. So the first one is, I can use it, can teach others, and offer great tips. I'm a Google Goddess guru. Mm-hmm. Is that anybody in this room? I don't even think that's me. I use it and I want to learn how to make more effective use of it in my classroom. I'd say that's probably where I am. I haven't used it, but I'm ready to take the leap and start using Google Classroom with my kids. Is that any of y'all? Mm-hmm. Okay. Mm-hmm. Cool. And then the last one was, I haven't used it and Google Classroom scares me.
I'm kind of there, too.
You there, too? Yeah, and there's nothing wrong with that. Technology can be scary, and it can be cumbersome in some ways. But it takes a little bit of planning on the front end to make sure that you're organized and you're uploading materials for the students and assignments for them to complete. But then it takes a lot of that organization and even some of the grading out of the way for you if you set it up correctly. So let's say that you guys answered that. What it would look like is the answers would pop up on the screen. We could actually look at it as a whole class and see, oh, it looks like two of you responded with the third answer. And so if it was a math lesson or something like that, you know, we could discuss why we came up with those answers. So, let's see. A lot of teachers approach Google Classroom with the mindset of, well, how can I just make my classroom paperless? But really, probably the right question to be asking is, how can I increase communication from student to student? Or how can I increase communication between me and my students and be able to give them effective feedback? And Google Classroom is pretty awesome with that. So, and you can go ahead and organize it in any way that you would like. Let me show you what it would look like on the teacher side. So let's say that I want my students to join my class. Let's say I've already created my class. I can go to Google Classroom and see the classes that I have. So this is my fifth grade class with my students. And then this is my training class that Miss Enoch is a part of. And y'all will be soon once we get the G Suite connected. So let me show you what my actual classroom looks like so you can see some of their work. So, for example, whenever you make an assignment, students will see the same timeline on their dashboard, and they're able to look at the assignments, click on them, and see all of the information about them. They can read directions. They can complete them within Google Drive. So, I'm going to click on this assignment. Here are the instructions. They need to complete all three levels of these math problems by typing your answer in the notes beneath each slide. Be sure to explain your answer. You can do it. And so you see off to the side, I can zoom in a little bit to see a little better.